So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Sienna Saints and the Kansas Jayhawks.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Jayhawks are in for what should be an easy one tonight, Dick, but how do they stay interested enough to win this game?
Interested enough, Brad, they still have to do the following things. First, set good interior screens to free up your big men on the block. Look to the inside first. Next, beware of turnovers. Protect the basketball. You want to minimize the amount of free possessions that you give to the opposition. Lastly, it's imperative that you win the battle of the boards.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Number four receives the pass. Down inside. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal. High post screen, gonna use it? Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Barishnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
Number three picks up the foul. First personal foul.
I tell you, what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
Hits that one. Good.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Down he goes, and no foul call either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
Now trying to feed the low block. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Trying to feed the low block. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. That's basic.
That's good. Number 24 is feeling good.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
For two, doesn't go. Looking for a good shot. From three-point land.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet J. Watch out, 5-second call approaching.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Three. He couldn't get it to fall. Go into the low block. He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
The power forward takes the feed. Fakes it.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Number 21, pump fakes. Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. The power forward gets the pass. Go goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. The power forward with the ball.
Double team now, bad angle.
Number 32 with the theft. Number 15 is feeling great right now.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
The small forward gets the ball. They work it around the perimeter.
Great anticipation defensively.
For the bucket. Sienna have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
Number 25 handles the feed from right of the circle. The Jayhawks have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire. Up and inside.
Looking for a good shot. The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle. A poor job defensively. No help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jump, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. From right of the circle, tries for two. On the dribble, gives it up. Turnaround jumper. The Jayhawks have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Thanks, Aaron.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Entry pass in the paint. Up! Easy one. He shoots from left of the circle. Off the rim and no good. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Pass, it's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Drops the bucket despite the harm. This place will go senseless, Dick, if they can get a stop. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. They'll work it around the arc.
There's the trap.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Problem with that when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
For the bucket, they still don't score. He puts it in with contact and all. Now they work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. The center takes the pass. Tries for two.
He missed the jumper off the nice screen.
For two. Can't get the shot to drop. The crowd really admires this young man.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
They're working around the perimeter. Jumps in. Too much contact there. It knocked him off balance a little. outside. Number 24 receives the ball from the top of the key. Way off target. They work it around the perimeter. He attempts the trifecta.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen, but the shot just didn't fall.
Looking for the foul. Basket falls despite the contact.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball in the deck. Where's he going?
Well, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Here they come with a double team to stop it. Kicks it out. He unloads a three. He hits the shot. With a big shot, he clangs the three-point attempt. At the half, the Jayhawks lead by six. Well, Dick, so far we've got a close one. Any play that sticks out to you as the highlight of the half?
This dunk right here dazzled the folks in the cheap seats, baby. I hope we see more of the same in the second half, Brad.
It's time to get back to the court, Dick, and see how their second half plays out. Kansas did a heck of a job shooting that ball in the first half.
I mean, no doubt about it. These boys are given too much time to shoot. If you ask me, they basically have time to wait and get a good shot. The defense was non-existent, Mr. Nessler.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Erin. Takes the three-pointer.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Looking for a good shot. In the paint. For the bucket. The Jayhawks have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Braddy's on fire.
Controlling the ball. The shooting guard takes the feed. Off the rim and no good. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential to the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of the post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
The small forward with the ball. Dumps it in. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
The small forward receives the pass. 10 on the shot clock. And the ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
Ball was knocked loose, but the offense got it back. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
It's stolen. Turnover. Great job knocking the ball loose, then chasing it down. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
And they get the turnover. This defense isn't yielding an inch.
Hey, the offense looks very timid, Brad. Nice high post screen. Watch this break right here.
Trying to draw some contact. Number 15 makes the finger roll.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
He looks for the bomb. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
On the outside, this young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
The fans know exactly how much he is.
Great swat.
Hey, looks like he was swatting flies in the summertime.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
For three, it won't fall. Picked out of the air. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man. Defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He intercepts it. The dribble, gives it up. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
The ball goes out of play. If his actions weren't deflating enough, how about this? He's definitely provoking this crowd.
Brad, the players are feeling it, and they want everyone to know that they're feeling it. Look at that spacing.
Gave it up for the bucket. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. Here's a double team. Steal. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stopped before any further damage is done. Guys?
The shot's off target.
The frustration right there.
The center gets the ball. Doesn't go. With a jump hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass. Up and inside.
Tries for two. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. He shoots from the top of the key.
Awesome job of running his guy into the screen to get off that jay.
On the outside, the small forward gets the pass. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Two shots. He misses the first shot. Doesn't go. Pulls down the rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way to be able to get some fast break opportunities.
The shooting guard takes the pass. Goes up for two. Easy one. Momentary look from three-point land. Oh, I don't know about that call.
That's one of those plays where I think the ref anticipated the foul and blew it down on instinct.
Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
Them both. He takes the shot. Off the rim and no good.
Very active defensively. A lot of pressure on the basketball.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Cross court, picks off the lazy pass. Try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
It's a 10-point spread, Dick.
Yeah, but 10 points can't be spread too thin, Brad.
From the top of the circle. No. The center handles the feed. And the ball goes out of bounds. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestle, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? Foul, and that stops the clock again. Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul.
Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
Makes the foul shot. puts up the tray. Good. Foul, and that stops the clock again. He steps up to the line. No doubt. Hits his second. With a great block. Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
The ball goes out of bounds.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The shooting guard handles the pass. 10 on the shot clock. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Dump it inside.
Got some room. Moving it around the perimeter. The point guard receives the ball. Time's up, Dick. How does a team just flat run out of time like that?
Hey, Brad, when a defense is playing like these are, the offensive players become unsure of what shot to take. So obviously this wastes time.
He shoots from the top of the key. Rims out. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Kansas played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nestler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.